Wisconsin, and the risks are back in the news following the death of Beverly Hills 90210 star Luke Perry.
Now, Perry was only 52 years old, so this clearly isn't just a concern for the elderly. We wanted to talk with our medical expert from SSM Health, Dr. Mandira Mehra, about what all of us should be doing to prevent a stroke. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm glad that this topic is in the news for such a sad reason, really, but I mean, we all need to be a little bit more aware of how much this is a concern for any age.
It's true. And, you know, we all remember Luke Perry, like you said, from 90210. He was that heartthrob. He was so good looking. And now you think, wow, 52, though, is still really young.
Right.
We often think of stroke as really a disease that affects the elderly, people over 65. And so if you're 30s, 40s, 50s, and you start exhibiting some of these symptoms, you might ignore them. And, of course, we know stroke can be deadly. Time is brain. So it's really, really crucial that you recognize those symptoms of stroke. In this case, whether you're older or younger, the symptoms can often be the same. And so we always think of the acronym BFAST. So BE stands for balance, vision, eyes changing, if you have difficulty seeing, double vision, blurred vision, anything like that. F stands for face, so we think of that facial droop. A stands for arms, so if you have arm weakness. S would be things like standing. Are you having difficulty standing, walking? And then T is time, so brain is time. If your brain isn't getting oxygen, it's like a heart attack of the brain. You really have to seek help immediately. Call 911, seek emergent care. In this case, if you are in your 30s, 40s, 50s, really in that younger category, kind of like Luke Perry, there may be different causes of stroke than the elderly. So when we think of elderly, we think of high blood pressure, cigarette smoke, diabetes, obesity, inactivity, kind of those regular risk factors that we even have for heart attack. In a younger population, like in Luke Perry's case, maybe it was things like a malformation in the brain, a vascular malformation. There could be a hole in the heart called a PFO. Other things like trauma, blood clots, really just different causes than you're looking at in the elderly population. So if you are in that younger category, don't ignore these neurologic symptoms, because again, you want to seek emergent care. And I know Luke Perry's family has not released details, and we respect that, and we don't want to make armchair diagnoses. But again, he was younger than you would expect for kind of a classic stroke situation.
For sure. Dr. Mehra, we also wanted to ask you about a study that came out that said 1 in 7 seniors, that's it, are asked about their memory, their thinking when they go into their primary care. So this is concerning, particularly with the uptick in Alzheimer's and dementia.
Exactly. And every time we talk about these numbers, they're astounding. We say, you know, 15 million by the year 2050, it's going to be even more. We're talking billions of people all across the globe that are going to suffer from different forms of Alzheimer's, dementia, just cognitive difficulties. And so if the primary care doctors or internal medicine doctors aren't doing a great job asking, this is where we always say, you know, if you're a patient, you're going to be your best advocate.
Yeah.
So you have to let your doctor know and say, you know what, I'm having some cognitive difficulties. Is this normal? Is this just age-related changes, or could this be those first signs and symptoms of Alzheimer's, dementia, other cognitive issues like that? So basically, if you're recognizing some of those symptoms, don't wait for your doctor to ask. You know, as your doctor, maybe we're thinking of your high blood pressure, maybe your diabetes, or thinking of all these other things. But it is absolutely crucial for timing, for planning, just for future staging also, to recognize those symptoms earlier so we can make a really good plan together.
Two really, really important topics to highlight this morning. Thank you so much for talking with us.
Great to be here.
Good to see you. All right, I know I have become dangerously close to a painful spill over the last week or so. Doctors in our area say the amount of injuries they have treated for people slipping and falling on the ice is much higher than normal.